Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. In this video, I wanted to explain degrees of freedom, give you an example of that, and then we'll use an example where we use a t-table. So degrees of freedom are the number of sample values that can vary. We use the abbreviation DF for degrees of freedom, and it's very simple. Just take your sample size and subtract 1 to get your degrees of freedom. But it's hard to kind of understand what that means, and I'll show you an example here. Suppose in order to be able to win a free cruise offered by your company, you have to average $10,000 in sales over a 6-month period. During the first 5 months, you don't think about it too much, but your sales come in at $12,900, $8,200, $7,500, $6,900, and $9,300. But the last month, you're like, oh man, I really want that cruise. And now, in order to reach your average, you have to get down to business and earn $15,200 to be able to get the cruise. In other words, you had 5 months of freedom. But that last month, you did not have the same freedom. That last month, you had to make up the difference to get to that $10,000 average. Your degrees of freedom were 6 minus 1, or 5 months of freedom. 1 month, you did not have any freedom. If you wanted that cruise, you had to get down to it. Okay, we're going to use a t-table for this example, but after this, we will use technology to find our t-values. We can do a lot more things with technology than we can do from a table. So you can use StatCrunch, you can use a good calculator if you have one, or you can use a website. Just go in and type in T calculator or T table calculator, and you can get one that way. First, we need to know our degrees of freedom. If N is 9, then our degrees of freedom of 9 minus 1 or 8. Over here to the side of your table, you have degrees of freedom. So we would be using this row right here where we have 8 degrees of freedom. And then the area in the two tails is, we know there's two tails because when we think about a confidence level of 95%, we're like those values in the middle, 95% are good ones, and then on the either end, those two tails, that's 5% of those kind of outlier values or significantly high or significantly low values. So we're looking for the area in two tails of 0.05. So start off by looking down the left side of your table for the DF that you're interested in, which we said was 8. And then we want to go along here and find the column that matches our what we're interested in. And this table that I got off the internet, which you could do too, is kind of nice because it has 3 different things up here. But we're looking at a confidence level of 95%. So that's the column we're interested in. The other thing we're looking in is a two-tail 0.05. So two-tail 0.05, notice that's the same column. And so we would then just go down to 8 and see that that's 2.3060. That's how you can use a t-table to find a critical value that you need to calculate margin of error, that you need to find your confidence interval. Okay, have a fantastic day, and subscribe if you want to see the rest of this series as they come out. Have a great day.